Starting off our evening with Claude Debussy from the Children's Corner Suite. That was The Gollywog's Cakewalk, played by the Dallas Brass. And I'm Cordelia Brown, and this is KPR, Kansas Public Radio. And we have some live piano music next by Claude Debussy and Stephen Spooner. KU professor of piano is here to play something. And Stephen, you're going to start off with The Sunken Cathedral.
Yes,
can you tell the little story about the city rising up out of the water?
Sure. You know, the 12 Debussy preludes are like gorgeous postcards, each one of them very evocative in mood and sound. And perhaps number 10 is one of the best known, The Sunken Cathedral, La Cathédrale Engloutie. And it's an interesting piece in that, you know, we have a recording of Debussy playing it himself. And in it, he actually goes against some of his own rhythmic markings, leading people to believe that maybe that's what he had in mind. So it's an interesting piece. I think he recognized it as one of his finest piano compositions. But the story is a Celtic legend where every so often, a city that has been overtaken by the sea, we can only imagine maybe a place in Normandy, would magically arise. And when the cathedral comes out of the ocean, we hear the ghosts of the old choir members and choristers singing. And then they come back down into the water, and one can really hear that. Of course, Debussy would have hated that we're talking about this before the music. He loved the idea of hearing the music first and then only looking at the title afterwards. That's the story in a nutshell.
All right, let's hear it.
Okay. Thank you.
What a great painting by Claude Debussy of the sunken cathedral, the cathedral that just once every so often would just rise up sparkling out of the sea. Brought to life by pianist Stephen Spooner, who is here in our live performance studio here at Kansas Public Radio. And Stephen will be giving a recital this Sunday evening, August 30th, in Swarthout, Sunday night, 7:30 p.m., and that's going to be one of the pieces on the program, Stephen?
Yes, I'm playing the entire book one of the Preludes.
And the name or the theme of the recital is Dedications. And tell about how you work that.
Well, I've spent a lot of my life listening to records since I was a little kid. And so the way that I came to the piano was actually through these recordings. And so it's only fitting that I dedicate to these great artists who inspired me so much a lot of my work. And so I like making projects that inspire me. And so this year is the 100th anniversary of the great pianist Sviatoslav Richter, one of my favorite pianists. And the famous critic Bryce Morrison said that his recording, along with Michelangeli and Kiesecking, of the Debussy Preludes are like on a mountain looking down on all the others. So the idea is that every piece that I will play on the program is dedicated to one of my favorite pianists.
So who will we honor next?
Oh, gosh. Well, we should do something kind of upbeat, I guess, after that. And one of my favorite pianists, and I can admit this now, and also the object of a very intense teenage crush, was Marta Argerich. And she's the great Argentinian pianist, one of the most incredible pianists of all time, and still active, still playing the piano. And so when I was an undergrad, I composed a piece for her.
All right, so this is by you.
Yes, this is by me, and it's called Etude Toccata a la Argerich. Argerich is famous for her repeated notes. She has the best repeated notes of any pianist. And she's also famous for a few pieces, like the Impressionist piece Gaspard de la Nuit of Ravel, and some other, I mean, anything she touches becomes her own. But she's known for this very fiery temperament at the piano. And because she's from Argentina, I made this sort of fiery, repeated note, Latin American sounding piece to honor her.
Okay, so it's written by you and played by you now.
Yes.
All right, Stephen Spooner. Oh, you're pretty good at those repeated notes too, Stephen.
Well, it's taken a lot of practice.
So that is a nod to the great pianist Marta Argerich, and it was called Etude?
Etude Toccata.
Etude Toccata, wonderful. And you'll play that Sunday night, won't you?
Yes,
okay.
Yes.
Some Scriabin?
Yes, this is also the 100th anniversary of Scriabin. And... you know, he died in 1915, and when he died, he was really one of the most progressive.
Oh, he was ahead of his time,
wasn't he? I mean, my gosh, when you think that the Debussy Preludes were composed in 1910, and the kinds of things that Scriabin was writing were really...
And doing. He was the one with the color organ, wasn't he?
Where yes.
He associated
synesthesia and
colors with different tones.
Yes. I was very happy of my piano student. My piano studio, I gave them the project to make a concert commemorating Scriabin. And they did such a great job. They kept me out of it. But they allowed me to to be part of it. And the piece I want to play for you is a piece associated with Mr. Horowitz. Mr. Horowitz, of course, was one of the great, I don't know about the greatest, but one of the very greatest interpreters of Scriabin's music. And he put this piece on many, many programs, and it's the Etude, Opus 2, Number 1. And it's interesting because it's such a part of the standard repertoire, this Etude, but it was written when Scriabin was 14 years old.
14.
And it's really quite prodigious. It's such a gorgeous piece.
Okay. Let's hear it, Stephen Spooner. Very nice. That was an etude by Scriabin, Russian composer, who, well, 2015 marks 100 years now that he's been gone. And Stephen Spooner, KU professor of piano, is our guest here in the live performance studio here at KPR, Kansas Public Radio. And he'll be giving a recital Sunday night, 7:30 p.m., Swarthout Recital Hall in Murphy Hall. If you haven't had a chance to see the refurbished Swarthout Hall, this would be a great time to go. It's
quite something.
Is it? I haven't seen it yet.
Yes, you
or heard it.
It's quite a beautiful renovation that was made for the hall. And part of the renovation was a brand new Homburg Steinway.
I was going to ask about the piano.
Yes.
So you approve?
I hope so. I chose it for the hall.
Oh, good. Okay. Well, that makes the concert extra special if you... You chose the piano. And also you can come to our website, kpr.ku.edu, to find out the particulars about the concert. What else can we? Can you give us a taste of?
Oh well, you know, I guess there are a number of things I could play, but I guess it would be nice to sort of finish with a wonderful kind of
Horowitz
gesture. You know, Horowitz is one of my favorite pianists. He still is. I still learn so much from him, even though he's been dead since 1989. Mm-hmm. He's still a very big presence in the world of piano playing. He was truly unique, great virtuoso, and great artist. And you know, Horowitz, he reached people outside of the classical realm, large part because of the transcriptions that he wrote. He wrote some transcriptions, virtuoso transcriptions, of pieces that the everyday person would know. And he said he was happy that they came to the concert to hear those things, but in the while sitting there, they mm-hmm. Also got Schumann, Kreisleriana, and Chopin, and Mozart, and a variety of other composers.
Yeah, he would do things like Stars and Stripes Forever.
Exactly, very like good. That. The Stars and Stripes Forever was a huge hit that audiences clamored for, and also his arrangements of Liszt pieces where he would expand the piece and make them even more brilliant than they already were. But the thing that I like very much is that Horowitz was interested in making transcriptions of pop songs. And at the very end of his life, and I'll show this clip at the concert, at the very end of his life, he's sitting there at the piano, and he's messing around, and what he's doing, he's playing his arrangement of T for Two. And that was an arrangement that he had played with for a large part of his career, and never recorded, and as far as I know, didn't play it a lot. And so it gave me this idea that if Horowitz were alive and active today.
Yeah, what would he be doing today?
Sort of mid-career.
To appeal to more people.
Exactly. I don't think he would be transcribing more Liszt pieces or doing jazz tunes. I think he would
Or even T for Two. I mean, that's from like 50 years ago or
exactly.
so. So yeah, he would do something more modern.
So I was thinking of some pieces that everyone knows and something that could work as a transcription is the Queen song, the great power rock
anthem.
Classic, We Are the Champions.
Sure, why not?
So those of you who are fans of Horowitz will recognize all of the tricks of Horowitz. A lot of his transcriptions are set in variation form, and they also utilize a lot of different kinds of piano playing, both powerful and what we would call tinkly, like a lot of notes, and they usually have a big ending because mm-hmm. he used them as concert enders or unforgettable encores.
Mm-hmm. So the Horowitz fans will recognize those, and the Queen fans will probably recognize the tune.
I hope so.
Okay, let's hear it.
Thank you.
virtuosic arrangement of We Are the Champions, the music of Queen, and it was spun here by Stephen Spooner, a la Horowitz, that run at the end. It sounded very Horowitz.
Oh, great.
Oh, it sounds really good.
Great, thank you.
If you'd like a chance to hear that amazing rendition again, Stephen Spooner, KU professor of piano, will be giving a great recital at Swarthout in Murphy Hall on the KU campus, 7:30 p.m. Sunday night. And it's kind of a dedication concert, and he has music that he's, each piece or so is dedicated to a performer who has influenced him by records he listened to when he was growing up. And it sounds like a great, great show.
Thanks.
Well, thanks for coming by, Stephen.
Oh, it's my pleasure.
Yeah, thank you. And it'll be a great show on Sunday. And this is KPR from the University of Kansas, your place to find NPR news and classical music.